Let me cut to then mRNA.
Okay, sure.
Because, like, I was a guy who did not want the COVID vaccine, but I do want research on mRNA.
Sure.
I don't think that that's crazy stuff.
Right.
In fact, when the next one comes along, I may want to be first online for it.
Right.
So I'm not down with, I like Bobby too, but I'm not down with him cutting that shit.
Yeah, so mRNA is in every single one of our cells. A DNA, RNA, RNA protein is kind of like the pathway. So mRNA itself is not bad. And the messaging around mRNA vaccines has led people to believe that anything that carries the letters mRNA is bad. We are all here, and we would not be here were it not for mRNA. mRNA vaccines are a relatively new technology, controversial because of their implementation during the COVID pandemic. And indeed, there are people out there who either insist on or have evidence that they have vaccine injuries of some sort. And that has been the rationale for removing this $500 million of support for mRNA research. I'm gonna get some hate, I might get some love, doesn't really matter to me. What is important for me to say is that there is incredible work on non-COVID related mRNA vaccines related to cancers and related to neurologic conditions and many genetic diseases and many, many things for which we would be absolutely foolish to ignore the technology.
Who's going
to
hate you for that?
Well,
idiots.
Many people. Well,
I mean, look.
That's fine.
I've been a vaccine skeptic. I'm a skeptic of everything medical.
Yeah.
Because everything medical. Let me ask you one final question. How much do you think we know? If you had 100%, is everything we could possibly know about medicine and how the body works? My difference with a lot of people is they think we're at like at 90%.
Oh,
I think we're at 20.
I think we're at 10 at best.
10.
And I'll give you a different answer. And I'm not trying to undercut the careers and trust in my friends who are physicians and scientists. I'm a scientist. I'm still tenured at Stanford, and I love science. I love medicine, and I believe in certain medications and supplements and nutrition and behaviors. I do think all of it's important. A good friend of mine who's a chair of neurosurgery, perhaps one of the greatest neurosurgeons ever to live, I asked him, I said, what percentage of the information in medical school textbooks in the United States and elsewhere is inaccurate, is just false, and we know it? And he said, at least half, given the new information. And then a good friend of mine said to him in the same conversation, what do you think the impact of that is on human health and the treatment of disease, et cetera? And he said, incalculable. We are still in our infancy of understanding. That is not to say we haven't made great discoveries.
Right.
And I should say, it's not to say that the NIH is a failed endeavor.
No.
It has returned beautifully in many areas of science and medicine. I do think an audit and a revision of what we're doing, a careful audit and revision is great, but we can't just throw things out because of what they're called.